Hello everyone, welcome to this video. This time around, we're going to be completing Lab 3 of the Virtual Infrastructure course. That means we're going to be creating a virtual machine. You've done this before, not necessarily in ESXi, so some of this should seem pretty familiar. Let's get started. I've already opened my vSphere client into ESXi 1 host, as you can see here. In order to start the virtual machine process, we're going to right-click on the host itself, and select New Virtual Machine. That will launch the New Virtual Machine wizard. I'm just going to pull this up a bit. And we'll work our way through. Now, notice by default, this is typical. For the lab, we're going to go through custom. You don't normally have to do that, but this will help just to see the different types of options that we have. I'll select custom and then start working our way through. Now, anything in custom can be reset later if you go through typical. So if you happen to miss custom, it's not the biggest deal in the world to go back and make changes after the fact. First thing we have to do, name the virtual machine. So according to the lab, this should be our first name, our host name, dash one. So I'm gonna say Jim01-1, that's my first VM. We'll click next. It wants to know the data store where we're going to store the files for the VM. There is only one, which is data store one, so that's the one that we're going to use. Click next. Now, it wants to know the virtual machine hardware version, and it's defaulted to the highest one, which is 8 in this particular case. The only time we would select these lower ones is if we want to export this virtual machine and have it run on an older version of the software. We do not, so we're going to keep that version. The type of operating system, now in this particular case, it is server 2003 32-bit. Keep the Windows, select the drop-down, and find 32-bit server 2003. Go next, number of virtual CPUs, one is fine, we're going to keep that. Amount of memory, defaults to a gigabyte. We're going to change this to 384 megabytes as per the lab. I'm going to select the gigabyte dropdown and change that to megabytes first and then put in 384. Something to be a bit careful of, if I put in the 384 first and then changed it from gigabytes to megabytes, it's going to think it means 384 gigabytes. So always remember to change the multiplier first and then afterwards put in the number. Virtual network, we want one virtual network adapter. It's going to be connected to the VM network, and that type of network adapter is fine. Keep all the defaults there. We're not going to change anything with the SCSI controller. That will ensure that we have the right driver loaded when the software starts to boot. We're going to create a new virtual disk. We don't have an existing one, so we'll keep that the way that it is. And how big is it going to be? According to the lab, we're going to make this 2 gigabytes. I'll change that from 8 to 2. And we're going to make it thin provision. So I'll make sure that I select thin provisioning. We're going to talk about these different types of provisioning a little bit later on. Go next. I'm not going to change the SCSI ID for the disk. I'll keep that the way that it is. Next, and here's the summary ready to complete. So I'm going to finish the virtual machine. And it will be created here in a second. You can see the task on the bottom, and here's the virtual machine that's now created. Couple of items, if we select the virtual machine and pick on summary, we can see the summary of the hardware settings that are over here, and then also as far as the resources are concerned. And the main thing I want to look at is this. We've provisioned a 2 gigabyte disk. It's only using about 1.5 kbytes, so that's the result of the disk being thin provisioned. It will only grow, that is the file that represents a disk will only grow as we start to store data in it. And finally down here, we're connected to the VM network. Now we're not quite ready yet in order to launch, and the reason that we're not is we need to attach to the ISO file for the distribution so that we can install. I'm gonna right click on the VM itself and select Edit Settings, which will bring up the settings box that we see here. Change I'm going to make is the DVD. So I'll select that. We'll see that this is on the client device. I want to attach to an ISO on the data store. So I'm going to pick data store ISO. I'll browse to that. And one thing to be a little bit careful of, you might be tempted to go into this folder called VM images. That's not where we want to go. We want to open data store one. We see this ISO images. I'll open that. And here is the server 2003 ISO. So I'll say OK. And the other thing we have to make sure that we do is select connect at power on. If we don't do that, what will happen is the ISO will be attached to the hardware, but it will never mount, and then Windows will not boot the installer. So select that, say OK, and we're now basically ready to go. So I'm going to power on the VM. I can either right-click and power it on, or I can select the power on button. I'm going to select that one. That will power on the VM. I'm also going to select this icon, which is going to open a console so I can see what it's doing. So select that. Here's the console window that pops up on the screen. We'll see that this is booting, and it's into the Windows setup. Now, this setup is basically automated. There's not much sense sitting here and watching it go through its paces for the next half hour while it deploys and runs all of its configuration. So I'm going to pause the video at this point in time, and I'll come back once it's ready for more input from us. See you in a few minutes. And we are back. So we can see here that it appears the OS is finished installing. Not quite. There's a couple things we have to do yet, so we're going to need to log on here. I'm going to log into this guy. Now notice that my pointer's captured because we have no VMware tools yet. I'm going to press Control-Alt to release that. And in order to send Control-Alt-Delete, I am going to click on VM and then guest and send Control-Alt-Delete. The other option is to press Control-Alt-Insert if you would prefer to do that. So administrator, remember from your sheets, this is a different password. This is password, not secret 55. So pass W0RD. And we're going to be logged in here in a minute. And there's a couple things we need to do from a cleanup perspective. Okay. First thing is that server 2003 expects a second CD. We're not going to be using that. So I'm just going to come down here and cancel. Get rid of that and terminate the setup, which is fine. Now we have a screen that comes up, which is basically asking about doing a post setup or post installation setup, which I do not want to do. So what I'm going to do here is just scroll down so I can find this finish. I will click that so that this is not going to come up again. Next time we log in. And finally, we have server manager. And I don't want this to come up every time we log in. So again, I'm just going to scroll down to the bottom here and click on don't display this page at login. Oops. Don't display this page at login. And close. Okay. The last step in task two is to disconnect the optical disk. So what I'm going to do is once again press Control-Alt so I can get my pointer back. I'm going to click on the optical disk here in the toolbar. I'm going to select that and say disconnect from the data store image. It's always a good idea to make sure that you disconnect from data store images. The reason is that if you're still connected, that means your VM is not going to be portable. It also means we can't migrate it to another host if there's a failure. So always make sure you're not kind of hanging on to ISO images when you don't need to. And that pretty much wraps up task two. Task three, basically what you're asked to do is kind of look at what we've done for storage. So I'm just going to minimize this window for a second and bring up the settings on the powered up VM as is requested. We'll see that if I select the disk itself, the hard disk one, over here on the right-hand side, it's thin provisioned and 2 gigabytes in size, which is what we wanted it to be. And then the other item is how much storage are we actually taking? So right now this says 109 megabytes. That's a bit light. If I say refresh the storage usage, we'll see that we're using a little over a gigabyte. So that virtual disk file is expanded from that 1.5 kbytes we started with up to a little bit over a gigabyte. Next step is to install VMware tools. We've done this before, but again, not in ESXi. Let me go and pull back that window that is the console. Again, I'm going to select on VM and then guest, and down at the bottom here we have install VMware tools. Select that, say go ahead. What will happen is the ISO with VMware tools will be mounted and launched, so we can see that the installer is now up. Once that pops up, we're going to do the same as what you've done with VMware-based virtual machines before. We'll just select all the defaults and install VMware tools. Once that's done, we'll reboot the VM, and then that task will be complete. So we see the installer launching here. Right, so click on next past the installer screen. Typical is fine. And install. This is going to take a few minutes. I think I'll pause the video here and I'll come back when this is finished. See you in a few minutes. And we're back. So the installation is now finished. I'll just click on finish. And tell it it's okay to reboot. When that's finished, the mouse performance will be much better and we won't have that captured mouse anymore. So moving the pointer around is going to be a lot easier. We'll just wait for a second here for the reboot to be completed. And then we have one more task to do to prep the virtual machine. That prep, by the way, is simply going to be for the labs. It doesn't have anything to do with the installation itself. That part is now complete. Right, so we're booted up. VM, guest, send control alt delete. Oops. Not quite done yet. There we go. And log in. All right, now we need to copy in a few files in order to complete the labs a little bit later on. I'm going to select up in the toolbar again on the DVD drive. I'm going to specify here I want to connect to an ISO image on a data store. So I'll pick that. Now again, we have to browse for this. This is down in the ISO images where the VMware tools ISOs are, because that was the last place that an ISO was mounted from. I can click on the dropdown. I'm going to go back up to data stores. I'm going to choose data store one and ISO images once again, and pick this class files vSphere ISO as specified in your lab sheet. So this is going to mount up. A couple things we have to do here. Let's shrink this window down a bit. We need to copy CPU busy VBS up onto our desktop. I'll do that. We need to copy IO meter up onto our desktop. I'll do that. And the other thing we need to do is run ext part self-extracting archive. I'll open that. Say I want to unzip. The default path is fine. Files are unzipped, close that, and basically that's all there is to it. So our VM's ready to go now. The only thing that we have to do is unmount the ISO image. Again, I'm going to come up here into VM and edit settings. That's another place we can get to the edit settings function. And once that's up, I'm going to pick the DVD drive and put that back to client device. And then I'll OK. And once I've done that, we will see that the mounted ISO disappears off the desktop. That's it. End of lab 3. Hope this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.